Hello everyone, today's lecture is indirect tooth cullet restoration part 1. Topic learning outcomes: define direct and indirect restorations, define inlay and onlay preparations, list the indications, contraindications, advantages and disadvantages of indirect tooth cullet restorations, describe CAD/CAM and summarize the clinical procedure, and describe briefly the clinical procedure, impression making and provisional restoration for indirect tooth cullet restorations. So in today's class we will be talking about the indirect and direct restoration, inlay and onlay, and their indications, contraindications, advantages and disadvantages, and we will summarize about the CAD/CAM. So coming to direct and indirect restorations. Direct restorations. This technique involves placing a soft or malleable filling into the prepared tooth and building up the tooth before the material sets hard. Indirect restoration. Restorations are fabricated outside of the mouth. Most indirect restorations are made on a replica of the prepared tooth in a dental laboratory by a trained technician. So basically we know what is direct and indirect. The one which we do directly onto the patient's tooth, that is what we call as direct restoration. For example, we will talk about a direct composite restoration, whereas indirect restorations, we will do restorations in a way like a two sittings, like first we do the preparation, then we will take an impression, after that we will send it to the laboratory to get the restoration done, then later the restoration comes back to the clinic, then we will load it to the tooth surface, something similar to like a crown. You do the restoration first, sorry, preparation first, then you take the impression, then you send it to the lab, then later the lab work comes, you check the high points and load it. The same way it is indirect and direct restorations. Inlay and onlay. So an inlay is a intracoronal indirect restoration that involves the occlusal and proximal surfaces of posterior teeth and may cap one or more but not all of the cusp. Onlay is a combination of intracoronal and extracoronal indirect restoration that involves the proximal surfaces of posterior teeth and it involves all of the cusp. So in the picture you can see what is an inlay and onlay. So inlay, basically it covers only one or two cusp, not all cusp, if you talk about the posterior teeth. Whereas an onlay, it is much more like a cusp capping. Mostly all of the cusps are covered. So basically we do the preparation something, for example, if you take it as a class 2 inlay, when you compare with a class 2 amalgam, there will be a occlusal convergence for the amalgam, whereas in inlay there will be a occlusal divergence, that is about 2 to 5%. So in a way you have to prepare, you have to take the impression, then you send it to the lab, then the lab will send back you the prepared restoration. So you have to check for the high points, then after that you will loot it. So that is about inlay and onlay. So coming to indications. So first one is aesthetics. So when you talk about aesthetics, the patient is talking about the stained tooth or if there is a discoloration of tooth, of the anterior tooth. So basically you can go for a veneer or indirect tooth color restoration. So that should be the first one. So basically it covers the areas of aesthetic important place for the patient. Then comes the large defects or previous restoration. So that involves the large compromised existing restoration, or there is a big large carious lesion, basically facio-lingually in wider, then it requires a cusp coverage. So in these conditions you can go for the indirect tooth color restoration. So basically the important thing we have to consider is aesthetics. Then sometimes the contact in the proximal area is not good enough to hold the food and all. So the occlusal table, you have to make sure there is no space. So in that case, because the contacts and contours are created outside the oral cavity, so you can reproduce a very good contact and contours. So these all conditions are considered for the indications for the indirect tooth colored restorations. Coming to the contraindication, so heavy occlusal forces, that is the first one. So ceramic restorations can fracture under heavy occlusal forces. For example, the patients having bruxism or clenching habits. So these patients, you have to do a other restoration which can hold the occlusal forces. So the, because the ceramic is so thin, when you cover the for the inlay or onlay, so you have to be really careful when you take up some cases with the habits. Then secondly, you talk about the patients with poor oral hygiene. So basically, if there is a poor oral hygiene, the maintenance will be really bad. So the patient with high caries index is also considered as not a good case for indirect tooth colored restorations. Then comes the, if there is any inadequate enamel left for bonding. So previously a restoration is placed over the enamel, so most of the enamel is removed and the restoration is placed. So basically indirect tooth colored restoration, they are bonded to the tooth structure. So if there is no adequate enamel to get the proper bonding, then the longevity of the restoration is questionable. So you have to make sure that adequate enamel is left there for the bonding purpose. Then inability to maintain a drive field, because we are dealing with a technique sensitive procedure, so we have to make sure that there is no saliva or any fluids present over the tooth surface, because that may affect the bonding of the tooth surface to the indirect tooth colored restoration. Then sometimes deep subgingival preparations are also not advised, because they are quite deep below the gingiva, so it is very difficult to isolate that area and go for a indirect tooth colored restoration. So these all are the few contraindications consider when you do a indirect tooth colored restorations. Advantages. First one, improved physical properties. So we have a wide variety of ceramic which is available for the tooth colored restoration. So they have a better physical properties when you compare to the composites. Second one is high aesthetics. Comparing to the composites, ceramics have definitely having an upper hand in aesthetics. So most of the indirect restorations are done with ceramics because they are highly aesthetic. Then comes the wear resistance. So comparing to the composite or direct restorations, wear resistance of ceramics is very good. So that is one thing you can compare with the composite. So we can say that ceramic has a very good wear resistance comparing to composite. Then reduced polymerization shrinkage. Here composites are not used because composites are having a polymerization shrinkage, we all know that. But ceramics, while luting, we are using the resin cement, so the polymerization shrinkage can be reduced within that way, and you can produce a very good contact and which is very nicely adapted towards the tooth surface in an inlay or onlay preparation. So marginally there might be a slight or a thin layer of luting agent is required for the adaptation of the inlay or onlay to the tooth surface. Again, coming to contacts and contours, more precise contact and contour can be created in the oral cavity because the restorations are done outside the oral cavity, because the impression is taken and we are doing the restoration outside the oral cavity. So you can create however you want, so that the reproducing the contact and contour is really good with indirect tooth colored restoration. Then the biocompatibility and good tissue response. So ceramics are considered as a chemically inert material, so they have excellent biocompatibility. Then coming to the tissue response, ceramics are very thin when we come contact to the cervical area, so there we don't have much irritation to the tissue surface, and so far the studies have shown that ceramics has a very good soft tissue response as well. So these all are the advantages of indirect tooth color restoration. And it's not that easy for you to think. Whenever in dentistry, if the advantage is asked, first thing you can write it as biocompatibility. Then comes the contact and contour. Whether it is an indirect tooth colored restoration, the first thing should be remember is contact and contour, because it is done outside the oral cavity. Then the third one you can remember is reduced polymerization shrinkage. Whenever you compare an indirect tooth colored restoration, it is always with composite. So you can write and think that one as the third or fourth one. Then of course highly aesthetic. Nobody will forget, I think. So easily you can find out 4 points. So it's not a difficult job for you to remember. So if you ask me, I will say the first one, highly aesthetic. Then I will say biocompatibility, contacts and contour, and reduced polymerization shrinkage. So it's easy to remember. This way you can catch it. So disadvantages. So the first thing you should think about disadvantage is expensive. Indirect tooth colored restorations are expensive. So increased cost and time. So that means because it's done with the ceramics, it is going to be expensive. You can think about that first. Then comes the time. Most of the time you require two appointments. Basically, first one you will do the preparation, then you will send it to the lab, then the second appointment you are going to fix it. Sometimes you need to go for a try-in, so it is time consuming. And sometimes if you have a CAD-CAM, chair-side CAD-CAM, then you can do it in a single appointment, but still you need a long time. So first one is increased cost and time. Second one is technique sensitive. So the restorations you made by the indirect tooth color restorations requires a high level of operator skill. That is first one. Then during the preparation and during the try-in, impression and bonding, it is like a technique sensitive procedure. So you can say that it's a disadvantage. Then come the need for special and a laboratory equipment. Of course you need a new machine and different machines and equipment for doing this procedure. So that is could be one disadvantage. Then brittleness of ceramic. So because in order to cover the tooth surface, we are going to cut a 1 or 2 mm, so it is going to be thin and they tend to fracture. So that is one disadvantage you can consider about the ceramics, that is brittleness. Then comes the wearing of the opposing dentition. That means if sometimes when you are giving a high point, sometimes it may abrade the opposing tooth structure. So that is one thing you have to consider when you give the preparation. So sometimes if it is a normal occlusion also, sometimes if you have a grinding habit, it might grind the opposing tooth. The ceramic might remove the opposing tooth slightly. Then low potential for repair. All know that about it. It's very difficult to repair. So these all are the disadvantages. So first thing, again I am telling you, you can think about is expensive. Then again technique sensitive. Then comes you think about the ceramics, brittleness of ceramics. Then you can think about the low potential for repair. So these all are the disadvantages of the indirect tooth colored restorations. Computer aided designing, computer aided manufacturing, CAD-CAM. So talking about CAD-CAM, Dr. Fankers was the first one to fabricate a crown with a CAD-CAM in 1971. Then a group of people created a chair-side inlay with the help of CAD-CAM in 1985. That is the history about CAD-CAM. So fabrication of a restoration with CAD-CAM system has functional components such as data capture, restoration design and restoration fabrication. So data capture means capture the data, that means the prepared tooth. That involves making an optical impression with the help of a scanner or an intraoral camera. That is what we can call it as data capture. Then comes to the restoration design. That means designing the restoration with the help of a software. Then last one is the restoration fabrication, that is about the fabrication of the prepared impression, that is the crown or the restoration. So just now we spoke about how a CAD CAM works. So basically we can classify into two steps, that is one is CAD and CAM. CAD means computer assisted designing and CAM means computer assisted manufacturing. So under designing there is digital impression and designing of the restoration, that is what just we spoke about. After the preparation of the tooth we have to take the three-dimensional image, that is what digital impression. Then the designing of the restoration with the help of CAD software. Then comes the CAM, that is the machining unit, that is with the help of the milling instrument we just create the restoration or the crown which we are going to do according to the software. So next is digital impression. There are two different types of scanners. How the digital impression is created? With the help of optical scanners and mechanical scanners. So the optical scanners work on the principle of collecting the three-dimensional data by the process called something like triangulation procedure. Basically there will be a light source and a receptor unit. So they held in a particular angle and the computer connects between the receptor and the light source and creates a three-dimensional data. That is how they collect the data. So how it works, you can see in the picture, there is a oral cavity, you can see a light is focused onto the tooth surface. So basically that is the receptor and light source. So you can see that light source, that is something like a scanner which scans that particular surface and it will be projected in the screen. Left side you can see the tooth surface like that. You can see at the same moment, you can make sure that all the surface wherever you are planning to scan for particular tooth. For example, if you are doing for a 4-6 inlay, you have to make sure the all surface has to be covered, because you have to make sure the particular area is covered and the opposing tooth, then only you will get the occlusion. So rest of the calculation will be done with the help of computer, but you have to make sure that you have scanned the surface properly. So basically it is like you are taking an impression, but only difference is that here it is digital, whereas you just basically load it into the tray and keep it in the oral cavity. Here we are particularly going to the vestibule, and whichever area you want to cover, that area has to be scanned properly. That is how it works with the optical scanners. Mechanical scanners is nothing much different. Only difference is that here the impression or the digital impression is made from a die, that is a cast, master cast. You taken an impression and a master cast is prepared, and from that it is recording the image. So it's not intraorally, it's something like a direct and indirect method. That is the difference. That is how you collect a digital impression. So next is designing of the restoration. So after the recording the impression with a scanner, a three-dimensional image is generated. Then the operator enters the data and confirms the features of the restoration or the preparation. Then the CAD CAM software designs the restoration with the insertion pathway. That is basically the CAD CAM program or the software allows you or propose you for a optimum or insertion path for the restoration, particular restoration. Then it will give you the block out the undercuts. Basically the software will ask you to block out the undercuts, which will be done with the help of a click of a button. Then comes with the marginal identification. Sometimes the program automatically detects, the software automatically detects the margin, but if you want to modify the margins, you can manually select the margins and cover it according to the preparation you have made. Then comes the virtual articulator. So it also allows you to create a virtual articulator that will give you the protrusive and the exclusive movements. so that you can see if there is any high points when you give in the normal occlusion or any retractive movements or any lateral movements. So you can check that way how you do in the normal articulators. Then comes the libraries, that is the software program will show you a different forms or different shapes of tooth or teeth. From there you can select which shape you want, and according to that you can do the contouring of the restoration. So according to that you can select and give the particular shape and size for the particular restoration or for the crown. So how the designing software works is like, it gives you an insertion and block outs the undercuts, then it creates automatically creates the margins or the margins, or if you want to modify it you can do it with the help manually, or manually you can do it. Then comes the articulation part. If you want you can check for the occlusion and lateral movements, you can do it with the help of the software. Then you can select the contours and shape of the cavity progression or for the restoration, and according to that you can do it. That is about the designing of the restoration. And in computer, if you ask me how it is seen, sometimes I have seen once or twice there will be something like that in the picture. You can see there will be a tooth structure on top of that, they will show some colors, so that means their bulk is more. So if you want you can reduce it, that part. So I don't know how you are able to understand it or not. So the from the moment if you record the data, that will be collected in the computer and that will be shown. After that if you key in the requirements, then that will show actually the where are the undercuts in a specific color. There will be color coding, and after that you can select the preparation, and you can give how you want to give the margin, something like you do a Photoshop, actually speaking. That is what exactly it will be, the margins. So you have to connect the dots and create the margin if you are doing it manually. If not, that will automatically detect the margins. Then articulator bit I never seen, so I'm not sure about it. Then the contours and different shapes, you can pick it according to the software use. Then it automatically gives you this is how it is going to come. So once it is finalized, then you can move on to the machining part, that is the milling part. So the last part is the CAM, that is the computer aided manufacturing. So the CAD-CAM generated restoration can either be fabricated through subtractive technique or the additive technique. So the subtractive technique means after the designing of the restoration, then the data for processing is calculated automatically by the computer. Once it is done, a prefabricated block of the ceramic is placed into the milling machine. There that will be shaped or contoured into the desired shape with the help of burrs, that is diamonds or diamond disc. That is what you can see in the picture. You can see a block is over there, and with the help of the burr that will be contoured into the restoration or the crown, whichever you have designed. That is how the subtractive technique works. Whereas in the additive method, a three-dimensional shape of the designed restoration or the preparation is made with the help of a laser beam by layer by layer. So a three-dimensional structure is created with the help of a laser, which is controlled by a computer controlled program. So basically that is also designed with the help of CAD, and it is controlled by a laser beam. Layer by layer it is added and the desired shape is created. So that is about CAD-CAM. I hope you all understood that. If you have any doubts, you can ask me or you can approach me later. Then in the next class we will be continuing the part 2, that is the clinical application, how we are going to do it, and the preparation, the looting, how is it, high points and all, temporization and all. So I hope you all understood it. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Thank you.